How to add contact on Zoom for Android. Like other platforms and communication tools, Zoom too uses a simple contact directory to keep you in touch with the people who matter. By default, your Zoom contacts list is populated with internal Zoom members, people who are at the same Zoom account. However, you can always add external members through their email's ID. If the person you're inviting is a Zoom member, they'll get a link to register at Zoom and connect to you. After they sign up successfully, you'll be able to chat, exchange media files, and hold instant Zoom meetings. Adding a contact on Zoom is a two-way street. After you successfully send an invite, the person on the other end will also need to accept the invite to complete the process. To add a new contact on Zoom, just open the app. You need to be connected with your account, so log in. If you don't have an account, you need to create one. Tap on the button called Contact. On this new section, you can add new contacts and also channel. What are the channels? Channels allow you to easily create private or public groups, send group chats, files, screen captures, images, and start an instant group meeting with or without video. Public channels can have up to 10,000 members. Private channels on paid accounts can have up to 5,000 members. And private channels on free accounts can have up to 500 members. So let's create, for now, a new contact. Tap on the plus icon from the top. Tap on Add the contact. Write the email that you want to add. Now tap Add to send the invite. The user will receive an invitation either in the app or at the email address. Wait until the person accepts the invitation. You see the person has already accepted the invitation. You will be able to create a meeting with this person, call them, and even chat with them if you tap on them. Also, you can mark a person as favorite on the top. This is how you add a contact on Zoom for Android. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. You can also watch more videos from the right. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.